So next topic natin ay about electrostatic. So Coulomb's law. So first law of electrostatic. So like charge repel and unlike charge attract each other. So let's say we have a positive charge na proton and another positive charge proton. So magre-repel siya, no? Sabi diyan, like charge repel. So negatively charged electron, then negatively charged electron, so repel siya, no? While unlike charge naman, so positive charge proton and negatively charged electron, so ano siya, no? Attract naman. So magdidikit siya, no? Attract. Well, ito naman, repel. Para sila repel. Ay. So, yan yung first law ng Coulomb's law. Then, second law of electrostatic, the force of attraction or repulsion of the charge is directly proportional to the product of two charge and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Ito. So, ito. So, the second law, so diniscuss yung force na yun. So, ito yung formula for the force. So, yan. Force. Okay. So, yung formula na yan is ay ginagamit para malaman yung force in between two charge. So, ito. Force in between two charge. Ayan, no? So, F. So, F is equal to Q2 over 4 pi EOER or another formula K Q1 Q2 over distance between the square of the distance between them. Ayan, no? Okay. So, itong formulas na to is for SI unit. So, ito, F is the force in Newton. Q1, Q2, charge in each body, column, or C. The absolute permittivity, 8.845 times 10 raised to negative 12. So, eto siya, no? So, sa calcio, nakalagay, shape constant, 32. Ayan, no? Saan yan? So, shape constant, 32. Equal. So, 8.85 times 10 to the negative 4. Farad meter. Oh. So, ito yung unit. Then, relative permittivity or dielectric constant. 1 is equal to free space. So, D is the distance between two bodies in meter. So, meron tayong K constant for SI na 9 times 10 raised to 9 SI unit and 1 naman kapag CJS unit or yung mga centimeter, gram, second. So, ang gagamitin mo yon yung K must be equal to 1. So, itong 9 times 10 raised to 9. So, dito siya galing, no? Diba ito yung K dito? Ito. Ito siya. Yan yung galing. So, K, kapag SI, so SI unit, 1 over 4 pi, shape constant, 32. shape constant 32 equal. So, ayan, no? Pag ni-round up mo, 9 times 10, raised to 9 din yan. Ayan. Okay? So, ito yung mga unit system. So, SI and CGS units. So, force, ang unit niya is N. Sa CGS naman, dyne. Yung charge, coulomb. Sa CGS is stat coulomb. And yung D, meters. Sa CGS naman, centimeters. Okay? So, one coulomb. So, conversion. One coulomb is equal to 3 times 10 raised to 9 stat coulomb. Then, two charge. Okay, one electron has a charge of +/-, so positive pag proton and negative naman pag electron. So plus minus 1.66 times 10 raised to 19. So 1.6 times 10 raised to negative 19 coulomb. So, one electron is equal, okay? One proton or one electron na to. One proton or one electron is equal to 1.6 times 10 raised to negative 19 coulomb. Okay, nakalagay naman dito. Okay. Okay, ano na natin? I-delete na natin. Okay. So, problem number 1. So, 2 charge Q1. So, given muna tayo Q1 is 3 times 10 to negative 8 coulomb. 8 coulomb. Then, Q2 is negative 4. So, ito ay electron. Times 10, negative 8 coulomb. Ito ay proton, ito ay electron. As separated, so may distance na 6 times 10, negative 3 meter. So what is the force? What is the force of one on the other? So meron tayong Q1. Ito yung Q1, ito naman yung Q2. So, ito ay positive, ito ay negative. So, ito ay mag repel. So, ito magre-repel. So, pinapahanap is yung force. Magre-repel siya, no? So, pinapahanap yung force. So, F sa formula, kailangan nyo i-recall, no? Yung mga formulas of electrostatic. So, F is K Q1 Q2 over D square. So, F. So, ito ay, ang mga units natin is ato, SI. So, meter. Ayan, SI yan lahat to. Coulomb and meter are all SI units. So, therefore, yung K natin kapag SI is 9 times 10 raised to 9. So, therefore, ito ay 9 times 10 raised to 9. Q1. So, direct substitution lang. 3 times 10, negative 8. And, negative 4 times 10, negative 8. Over 6. Over 6 times 10, negative 3 meter squared. So, therefore, ang lalabas niyan is a unit of Newton. So, ito na siya, no? So, huwag na natin input. So, ang answer dito is 0.3 Newton. Andito naman, no? F is 0.3 Newton. problem number 2. Okay, problem number 2. 2 electrons in a vacuum. So 2 electrons. Negative. Two electrons in a vacuum, so Q and negative Q, so electron Q1, Q2. So mag-repel siya kasi parehas ng sign. So meron tayong F na 2 times 10 negative 15 Newton. How far apart the electron? So, since ito ay Newton, so ito ay SI. So, therefore, yung K natin is 9 times 10 raised to 9. Then, next is, i-recall nyo yung formulas. Ano ang formulas ng force between protons and electrons? So, K, Q1, Q2 over D square. So, since Q1 is equal to Q2, so magiging itong multiply mo yan, so rules of math, magiging siyang Q squared na lang, no? Rules of math. So exponent law, laws of exponent. So K is 2 times 10 negative 15 is equal to 9 times 10 raised to 9. Then yung Q is ano siya, no? Saan siya manggagaling? So anong values ng ano electron? So ilan, so ilang column ba yung electron? Shape constant number 23. Ayan, no? 1 electron or proton is equal to 1.60 times 10 negative 19. Okay? 1 electron or proton is 1.6 times 10 negative 19. So, ito yan, no? Ito siya, no? Kanina, oh. Ayan, no? 1 electron has a charge of 1.6 times 10 negative 19. So E is squared divided by the distance, okay, D squared. So input natin 2 times 10 negative 15 equal 9 times 10 raised to 9 shape constant, ito shape constant 23. Okay, i-squared natin kasi identical. Then yung D, kung ano yung unknown, gawin natin X. So D squared, no? Then shape solve for X equal. Okay, so nakansolve siya, no? So, shift solve na lang sana natin. So, ibig sabihin, so, nakuha natin is yung imaginary part niya. So, since ito ay squared, so, this squared, di ba? So, ito ay 2 roots, so, positive and negative. So, nakuha natin dito is ay negative. So, therefore, magkikansolve siya, no? So, equate to this squared or cross multiply, so magiging siyang 9 times 10 raised to 9 E squared over 2 times 10 negative 15. So i-delete natin to. So this squared magiging square root, no? Kaya ang ganyan, pwede ng ganyan. Lalabas yung D. Tapos, ito, square root nyo na. So, plus, minus, no? Plus, minus. So 3.39 times 10 negative 7 meter. Kasi puro SI unit yung mga given, therefore yung D SI unit din. Square root, so 9 times 10 raised to 9, shape constant 23 squared over 2 times 10 negative 15 equals, so 3.39 times 10 negative 7 meters. Next problem number 3. So 2 charge, so 2C column. So problem number 3. So 2 charge 2C column and 5C column are 10 meters apart. So we have 2C and 5C who are who are 10 meters apart. A third charge of negative 3C are placed 2 meters away from 2C. So 2 meters away from 2C. So, ibig sabihin ng from, ibig sabihin niyan mula, di ba? So, oh, so where are you from? O saan daw nagmula, no? Where are you from? So, negative 3 column are placed, a third charge are placed of negative 3 column placed 2 meters away from 2C. Determine the force acting on 3C. So, ang distance nito ay mula dito. So, let's say ito ano, Q1, Q2, then yung third charge, Q3. So, ang distance between Q1 and Q2 is 10 meters. So, ibig sabihin, ito, so 10 minus 8 is at 10 minus 2 is 2, 8 meters. So, 10 minus 2, 8 meters. So, 2 plus 8 is 10. Okay. So, ang pinapahanap is yung net force dito. So, net force Q3. Net force on Q3. So, pag sinabing net force on Q3, focus tayo sa movement ng Q3. So, focus tayo sa movement ng Q3. So, eto muna tayo, no, Q1 and Q3. So, focus tayo sa movement ng Q3. Positive and negative. Di ba? Positive and negative repel. So, saan ang movement ng Q3 kung repel yan? Going to the, dito no, F, dapat pala attract, no, positive and negative, so attract. So, ibig sabihin, ang movement ng Q3, papunta doon sa Q1. So, ibig sabihin, eto yan, no, force, three. So yung charge 3 pupunta doon sa 1, kaya force 3 1. Okay, next naman dito naman sa F, Q3 and Q2, so negative and positive attract, no, so anong movement ng negative 3 column? So ang moment ng negative 3 column papunta doon sa Q2. So therefore, force 3 papuntang 2. Okay? Net force. So vector lang to, addition of vector. F3 to papuntang positive side. So F3 to papuntang positive side. And F3 1 papuntang negative side. So eto na yung F net sa on Q3. Okay, so kailangan natin i-minus. So F net on 3. So F3 2. So formula. So formulas natin eto no. F, 'di ba? K Q1 Q2 over D squared. So F3 2. F3 2. So ano yung so ano yung K? 9 times 10 raised to 9. Then, ano yung 3? Ito siya, no? So, ibigay lang muna natin yung sign. So, 3. Then, ano yung 2? Tapos na tayo sa 3. Ano yung 2? So, ano yung 2? 5. Minus, so 9 times 10 raised to 9, so ano yung 3? So 3. Ano yung 1? 2. So nakalimutan natin yung D. So distance between 3 to, so distance between 3 to is, distance between 3 to is 8. Okay, then minus ano yung distance between 3 and 1? 3 and 1 is 2. Okay? So ayan naman siya, no? Therefore F net on 3 is equal to negative 1.13 times 10 raised to 10. So negative means going to the negative direction, going to the left. So force is positive. So ang magnitude niya is positive, no? Magnitude positive. While yung negative sign indicate the direction only, no? So what? So letter B. So what is the net force acting on Q2? Okay, so delete muna natin, no? Shadong magulo. So F net on Q2. So focus tayo doon sa movement ng what is the net force? At ito to. F net on Q2, so focus doon tayo sa movement ng Q2. Okay. Yung Q2 experience a force dito. Mag-experience siya ng force mula sa galing sa Q3 and force galing sa Q1. So meron tayong in-expect na dalawang force. So focus doon sa movement ng Q2. So Q2 ano ba yung force na ma-experience niya. So, let's say, eto muna tayo sa Q3 and Q2. So, yung movement ng, ano, so, negative-positive. Dito muna tayo sa 3 and 2. 3 and 2. So, na ano, opposite, ano, no? Opposite charge attract. So, ibig sabihin, yung movement ng 2, so, pupunta siya ngayon sa 3. So, ibig sabihin, papunta siya doon sa 3. F2, papuntang 3. Then, yung ano, Q2, mag-experience siya ng force mula sa Q1. Doon naman tayo sa 1 and 2. Saan ang movement ng 2? So, positive, no? Repel. So, ibig sabihin, ang movement niya papunta dito. F1 and 2. So, balik na rin natin, no? So, gawin na natin 2 and 1. F, 2, and... So, okay lang nung magkabaliktad. F, 1, and 2. So, ganun na lang. So, FQ2. So, yung F2-3 puntang negative direction. So, F1-2 papuntang positive direction. Minus F2-3 papuntang negative direction. So, next, yung formulas, no? So, eto. F is equal to 9 times 10 raised to 9. Q1, Q2 over D squared. So, 9 times 10 raised to 9. So, ano yung Q1? 2. So, titingnan nyo yung mga subscript, no? Ano yung Q2? Q2 is 5. Then, distance between 1 and 2. Distance between 1 and 2 is 10. Ayan, no? 8 plus 2. So, 10. Squared minus 9 times 10 raised to 9. So, ano yung Q2? Ano yung Q2? So, 5. Ano yung Q3? Negative 3. So, lagay lang natin yung 3. Huwag natin include yung sign kasi kinonsider na natin dito. Then, distance between 2 and 3. 2 and 3 is 8. So, 8 squared. Okay. So, equal. So, nakalagay naman siya dito. Huwag na nating input. So, negative 1.20 times 10 raised to 9. So, going left, no? Kasi nag-negative. So, Newton. Okay, so, delete na natin. So, 3 equal positive charge of 10 stat column. Each are located at the vertices of an equilateral triangle 2cm leg. So, what is the magnitude of the force acting on each charge? 10 stat column. So, Q is CGS, no? Q1, Q2, and Q3 are 10 stat column. Yung distance between them is 2 cm. So, cm, no? CGS. What is the force acting on each charge? So, meron tayong nag-form siya ng equilateral triangle. So, gaya ganito, no? So, Q1, Q2, and ito naman dito yung banda yung Q3. So, pinapahanap is yung net force. So, since equal yung ano, yung charge is equal, and yung distance is equal, then ano pa siya, no? Equilateral triangle. So, equilateral triangle. So, therefore, yung net force niya is also F net is equal. So, yung net dito, F net, then dito naman yung F net is also equal. Iba-iba lang yung direction, ano? Okay, tandaan nyo, iba-iba lang yung direction. Pero yung magnitude, equal yan. So, ngayon, gawin natin, dito na lang tayo magkukuha ng net force. Kasi simple lang. Kasi ito, ano na siya, no? Horizontal. Horizontal. Or pwede naman dito. Pero mas simple dito, no? Mas simple kapag dito tayo sa Q3. Kasi positive na siya, tapos horizontal pa. Okay. So, focus doon sa movement ng Q3. Focus tayo doon sa movement ng Q3. So, yung charge 3, Q3, mag-i-experience siya ng force galing dito sa Q2, and mag-i-experience siya ng force galing din dito sa Q1. Okay, mag-i-experience siya ng force. Okay, focus din tayo sa movement ng Q3. So, ano muna tayo, no? 2 and 3. So, since positive siya, no? Para puro positive siya, magre-repel. So, ibig sabihin, ang movement niya papunta dito. So, horizontal. F. 2. Papuntang 3. Ito naman, yung force naman galing dito. So, since, same sign, so repel. So, ang movement ng Q3, papunta dito kasi repel. Okay, so since ito equilateral, triangle, so ito ay 60. So, therefore, ito ay 60. Ngayon, i-shortcut na lang natin. So, ito, ano yung polar form nito? So, since kung ito yung reference, lagi dito ang reference sa shortcut, ha? So, kung ito ay, polar form, so, FQ3 is equal to F 2-3 angle 0. So, ito yung reference natin, no? Ito yung reference. Then, going paganyan, positive counter clockwise. Positive. Paganyan naman, pagpababa tayo, negative theta, no? Sayad lang natin, di ba? Pag F net, yan yung resultant force. So, i-add lang natin. So, F net is the resultant force. So, plus. So, ito ay F13. So, F13 angle. So, negative 60, no? Kasi pa, pababa. So, negative 60. So, kunin muna natin yung F2, 3. So, eto siya, no? F23 and F13 are equal, so same charge kasi siya. Same charge kasi siya and same din yung distance. So, mas mapadala yung solution nyo. So, K is equal to 1 kasi CGS yung mga given. So, K times Q. So, magiging siyang squared, no? Kasi equal yung Q1 and Q2 and Q3. So, 10 squared over 2 square. So, yun yung distance. So, equal sa 25 dyne. Oh, CGS. So, ngayon, ano mo siya, no? 25 angle 0 plus 25 angle negative 60. Okay, then punta tayo sa calculator. Dapat naka-complex mode 2. 25 shift angle 0. So since resultant plus 25 shift angle negative 60. Then shift to number 3. So, dapat naka polar form. So, equal. So, 25 square root of 3, negative 30. So, F on Q3 is 25 square root of 3, angle negative 30. So, 43.30. So, yung unit niya is dyne kasi CGS. So, ibig sabihin, ang net, ang FQ3 is nandito siya, banda, no? FQ3. So, negative 30, ibig sabihin pa, baba. So, ito ay negative 30. Okay. So, ito yung part 1 regarding pa lang to dito sa first law and second law. So, ito yung shortcut, no? Okay. So, shortcut din na lang natin para di na kayo mahirapan.